Hey, what's up you guys? This is Rob from The Gay Guy Plays, and today I'll be giving you the rundown on one of the most popular Warframes in-game, the Rhino. So I think I'm going to have to add a disclaimer to this video, as I'm not a big fan of Rhino, or more accurately, I'm not the biggest fan of a certain subsection of Rhino players. I find that there are two types of Rhinos out there. They're either really skilled and know how to use their frame to make the mission go smoothly, or they're total douchebags that use Iron Skin and Rhino Stomp to cover up the fact that they're shitty players. Now that I've gotten that out of my system, I will say that Rhino is arguably one of the best Warframes in-game. His parts are dropped by the Jackal in the Fossa assassination mission in Venus. You can finish him off by picking up his blueprints in the market for 35,000 credits. And for all the wallet warriors out there, you can pick him up supercharged along with an additional Warframe slot for 375 platinum. Now let's take a look at what all the Rhino heads are so juiced about. His first ability, Rhino Charge, bursts forward a short distance, smashing and knocking down any enemies in his path. The skill is amazing if you inadvertently get trapped in an awkward position and need a little bit of CC in order to get out. Now, Iron Skin is the ability that makes Rhino feel like, well, Rhino. He creates a physical barrier that protects him from incoming damage, knockdowns, knockbacks, energy drains, and poison. So, just do note that this ability isn't affected by duration increasing mods, as it functions more like a ward, absorbing a set amount of damage before it expires. The graphics on this skin can serve as a bit of a hint as to when it's running out. In his next ability, Rhino lets out a mighty roar that increases the damage of all nearby Warframes, affecting both weapon damage and Warframe ability damage. This is one of the skills that is a must at higher levels, especially if you're grouped up. Think of how much damage your group's Nova can do with Antimatter Drop and Molecular Prime, or think of how hard you're going to hit enemies that are affected by Banshee's Sonar, or Aloki, Stealth, with Galateen charging down enemies. His final ability is Rhino Stomp. Rhino slams the ground, sending out a massive shockwave that deals damage and momentarily locks any remaining enemies in stasis. Now, as many of the veterans of this game know, late game damage on ultimates isn't the most amazing thing out there. But what makes this ability mind-blowing is the fact that it will literally lock down any enemies that weren't killed by the initial damage. So while at higher levels you may not kill an ancient outright, at max rank you can lock it down for 8 seconds and you and your team can proceed to clean up. So a couple tips for Rhino. First off, be sure to pick up the Vanguard Alternate Helm. Not only does it look badass, but it also increases run speed by 25%,
while decreasing his power strength by 5%.
Really, that 5% isn't much to worry about. I personally feel that this helmet is a must and makes him much more playable, since his base run speed is pretty much a crawl. I mean, come on, he had to have some kind of trade-off for all that awesomeness. Next, be aware that once you get into higher levels, Iron Skin becomes less and less effective due to the increasing amount of damage that enemies are going to be doing to it. So don't be surprised, pay attention, take cover, and refresh when needed. Lastly, don't be a douchebag, and don't be a press forward a winner. You're all better than that. All in all, Rhino is a great Warframe that's awesome at pretty much everything he does. His abilities are straightforward and simple enough for new players to embrace. His high base shields, health, and armor allow you to make mistakes without punishing you too harshly. For advanced players, his wide array of skills make him extremely moddable to fit several different roles, and to be honest, after playing some of the more skill-intensive frames, it's just nice to slip on your Rhino and zone out in easy mode. Thank you all for watching another episode of The Rundown. If you enjoyed the video and I didn't happen to offend you, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe for more gaming content here at A Gay Guy Plays.
Look at you all naked. I think it's about time for a three-way.